First things first, floor door. Door. Whisper room. Exit to the lower left. Lower left. Wee.
Ow.
Get off me. Yeah, okay. So we've already got the health number. Through here. Our life bar is a bit silly at this point, isn't it? It all helps. Exit back to the whisper room, then exit to the lower right to return to the vertical room full of vine blades. Exit to the lower right. Whoop. Lower right. Right, alright. I think we're there. Kill the uppermost ones to get out of the way, and then you spot a drone passage. Oh, I see. Yeah, I think I've already looked at it. I think I've already done it. Yeah, I've already done this. Pretty sure. So we'll just hop out this way. Alright, so now that we've done... Jesus Christ, game! Why it glitches out like that? I have no idea. Okay, this next upgrade can be a bit tricky. We've got all the tools we need to 100% area. We need to 100% this area, so might as well give it a try. For this next upgrade, you want to descend into the large open area in the lower left section of the map. So basically, go down. Get a nice save here. Good. Okay. Drop down and then head left and then leap across to another structure. Fight your way to the left end. Did not mean to do that. Cool. Alright, so now that I'm here. To do this, you'll need some finesse with your drone teleport and tracer's warp. Okay. Jump up to see a room to the upper left. You want to get in there. Yeah, I know I want to get in there because I saw it. Yeah, I want to get there. To do this, you'll need to use some finesse. Just a bit to the right is a small mound of stone. Stand on the... Okay, right. Stand on the uppermost, yep. Okay. So here... I think I see what it wants. Okay. Ah. That's is indeed very tricky. Very tricky. Damn it. It's not a small amount of finesse, it's a lot of finesse. I'll get it though. So just a practice one. It's not gonna work. It's not gonna want it either. Shit. I think I'm gonna have to do it with the directional pad rather than the analog, because I'm just not happening with the analog. Here we go. Now it's with the D-pad. Bioflux accelerator causes mutation to max health. Okay, well, I'm not max health yet. Okay. Boop, 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 boop. It took BK Stunt a ton of tries. Okay. Anyhow, this is the second Bioflux Accelerator we picked up, and it adds two more arms to your back when you're at full health, doubling the firepower. Okay. Once you have that upgrade, drop down and head to the far left to reach the door. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Mind me. Hoo-yah! Nope. 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 Shit. Poopy. There we go. Oh, I see. Yep, yep, yep. Hey. that last little bit. I reckon I can. I think I can. Ooh. Yep, I got... Yep, I'm a mutant now. I'll have to blow my nose soon, but that was pretty bad. No. Okay. Got it. You know what? I'm gonna clean my glasses because they're filthy. I honestly thought that the music would be better, but it's passable only. This whole game feels like a passable Metroid. Doesn't feel like it's, I mean, it's technically sound, it's just, it's not blowing me away, you know what I mean? I think where really falls short is its story. Maybe, like, it'll make more sense and it'll be like, wow, close to the end, but, you know, doubtful. Alright, let's get back into it. There's a little, it's a little wee little bit there, but... What other bits? Okay, one more. And the worst part is we've got to backtrack. What? Make your way back to the save room near where you encounter the abandoned clone. Really? Abandoned clone. I'm not quite sure where that was.